Good morning, everybody. Happy Friday. I think it's about time to start our first show for the day. I want to welcome everybody. Welcome to Grimco's exclusive virtual trade show. We're here at the Grimco Chicago Hub, where we are sitting in a brand new 100,000 square foot facility. And the most impressive, although the warehouse is beautiful, we've got a magnificent 5,000 square foot demo center here where we'll be bringing you the trade show live today. So in this demo center, we do all kinds of things. Customers like to come in, sample some equipment, see how they work. We give virtual live demos if you'd like. We've got Neil, who is one of the experts in the field, with all the machines in here. And we can really customize any kind of training, education, experience that you want. If you're interested in any kind of new equipment, reach out to us, and odds are you'll be back in this room with us talking about your specific needs. So first of all, for anybody that doesn't know the background, Grimco was founded in 1875 in St. Louis, Missouri. So we've been around for a minute, and we are a wholesale distributor for signs and manufacturing. We have anything from LEDs to print media, printers, other fabrication equipment, traffic signs, rigid substrates, and a whole lot more. So we're committed to helping sign and graphic manufacturers grow with over 50 locations in the United States and Canada. So today's format for the trade shows, we're gonna take this as 30-minute presentations followed by 15-minute Q&A sections. And each section is going to have a panelist with industry experts to help answer all of your questions live throughout the presentations. During this presentation this morning, we've got Kyle Moore with us as an expert panelist. Kyle, can you introduce yourself to everybody?
Yeah, good morning, everybody. I'm the voice in the sky here. My name's Kyle Moore. I've worked for Grimco for about 6.5 years. Have done everything from printer sales to wrap media to rigid boards to LED lighting as well. So I'm happy to help out as best I can.
Awesome. So yeah, keep those fire away on those questions. You'll see a little section on your Zoom screen where you can ask questions throughout the presentation. And then we'll pick some for the end if we want to answer them live so everybody can get the education on those. So let's get started. My name is Erin Quirarte. I am the product line manager for Briteline and Duratex. I've been with Grimco for 13 years, who's counting? And recently just started traveling to branches, working with customers, developing new products for Briteline and Duratex. I work directly with a lot of manufacturers to make sure all of our products are meeting our expectations and keeping our customers happy. If you guys take a chance to go on grimco.com, any Briteline product that you search for or look at that page, you'll see on the bottom a PDF. It is a Briteline application guide. Take a look at that. There's a lot of stuff in this line. There's a lot of materials. We've expanded it as we see the need for different applications from our customers. We want to keep bringing you innovative products that are versatile and fitting your needs while keeping your costs reasonable. I know everybody is here today to talk about WrapCAST. Neil over here, unfortunately, is not mic'd up, so he's not going to have any of his one-liners coming out, but he is wrapping a drum that we'll get to here in a little bit. But first, I feel it's very, very important to do a recap from the first trade show that we did about 2 months ago. I say this because there are two extremely, extremely hot applications right now, as you can imagine, as you see here on the floor, floor graphics, social distancing decals. Distributors, manufacturers, converters are scrambling behind the scenes to keep up with the high demand for this application that you are seeing everywhere. And honestly, I personally don't feel like this is going to die down anytime soon. And being that these are short-term graphics, you're going to see repeat business. You're going to start seeing sponsorships on these. So your customers are going to need to replace these again and again. Briteline has several solutions for you when it comes to floor graphics, what we call a one-step process and a two-step process. What we have here on the floor is the multi-grip, so we'll start with that. Again, we touched on this in the first trade show, but anybody that wasn't there, we want to keep you up to speed. So the one-step process, as you'll hear maybe, this is a textured 14 mil fabric reinforced PVC vinyl. And the beauty about this is you're going to print on it and apply it. There's no lamination required, and there's no heat needed whenever you're putting it on the surface. And this is called Briteline Multi-Grip, and honestly, it can go on nearly any surface that you choose. You can't see on the film, on the camera, but there is some fabric reinforcement here that makes it extremely durable and strong. It can go anywhere from sealed concrete, sidewalks, into your floors, carpet, brick walls, you name it. But I do want to keep in mind that this is a, if you're putting this outdoors on sidewalks and a monsoon rainstorm comes through, it's going to limit that durability that it can have. The other process I wanted to talk about quickly is the two-step process. As you can imagine, we're talking vinyl and laminate. So you've got some options when it comes to this solution. You're going to print on the vinyl and put the OL or put the OLFL laminates, which we call, which are anti-slip UL approved. So I am 3210. Keep that in mind. I am 3210. That is for smooth interior floors. It's got a nice removable adhesive and it prints beautifully, and you can choose between a matte or gloss laminate to go on top. This is a gloss finish. A lot of people question, how can it be slip resistant when it's a gloss finish? It has a slight embossment, but this is a strong lamination on here. This is about 6 mil thick, and it does have the approved slip resistancy. So just this week, we've introduced another floor graphic film that's designed specifically for carpets. This is referred to as IM3211. So the difference between the two, when you have a carpet, a commercial grade carpet with that low nap and a tight weave to not have a whole lot of texture, you see them a lot in banks or shoe stores, some hotels, saw one last night, you need a little bit more tack to the glue. It needs to be a tackier adhesive to grab onto that carpet, but still remove clean and not leave any adhesive behind. So you've got your one-step multi-grip solution or your two-step film and lamination, both options available at Briteline. We're getting inventory in every day. Thousands of rolls are going out as soon as it comes in. It's high demand and it's not going to go anywhere. Last thing I want to touch on the floor graphics. Keep in mind, one-step process, rubber soles, feet, shoes, strollers are coming in direct contact with that ink. So if you want a longer life or want your ink to stay brighter longer, you may want to consider doing the two-step process. So again, floor graphics, if you're not talking to your customers about them, you need to start today because everybody's going to need them as the country opens up slowly state by state. So that is my floor graphics. Also, I want to talk to everybody about wall applications. As you know, wall applications is something that continues to grow year over year. If you look at the stats, the demand is increasing and it's not slowing down. So when you think wall graphics and you think Briteline, think Rad Graphics. So Rad Graphics is a pretty versatile product. We've got people using it for other things other than walls, we're finding out. We introduced a new finish that I wanted to touch base with you guys on. So Rad Graphics is offered in a smooth vinyl, a textile, which is actually a woven polyester, so more like a wall fabric, if you will, and an embossed canvas. So basically that's the smooth vinyl version that's stamped with a canvas print, if you want to visualize it. All of these films are 6 to 7 mil in thickness, and they're extremely removable. Because what's the most important thing when it comes to wall graphics? It's got to print well, it's got to remove clean and not damage the wall, but it's also got to be at a price point that you can afford and you can take that business and get your customers on the hook. So these decals right here, these were applied a couple months ago. This is a smooth vinyl version, but I just want to demonstrate, you know, the product itself, if your vinyl is not removing this clean and it's up for 6 months, you're probably going to damage the wall whenever it comes down. And you'll notice that a lot of wall graphics, especially the Rad Graphics, look how nice it reapplies. Just simply take it down, reposition it, put it back up. We've all seen the ads for Fathead and stuff like that. Same concept. But the most important thing that I come across almost every week, I would say, is improper wall prep. This is probably one of the most important things when it comes to wall graphics. And unfortunately, it's a step that's skipped. So think about this. Not only are you prepping the wall to remove any debris, dust, dirt, fingerprints, kid fingers, God knows what could be on there. But during the outgassing process, when a wall is painted, during that outgassing process that can take up to 6 weeks, there's actually a film left behind, like an oil residue. That prevents a good adhesion with your wall graphics. So please, please, please don't skip this process. Use the isopropyl alcohol and water mixture, 70-30, 70 alcohol, 30 water, and wipe that wall down and make sure you allow plenty of time for it to dry and breathe and then get started applying. So, little recap there. So let's get to the reason why everybody tuned in today and why you stopped by my booth. Let's talk about WrapCAST. So we'll get to that back here, Wade. So I first want to answer some questions that you may be thinking or I've been asked, like why a cast product. Why would Briteline add a cast line? They've always been a, you know, intermediate calendared product line. Well, we, after a lot of investigation and a lot of communicating back and forth with our customers to develop new products, there is a proven need for a true cast conformable kit under that $900 range. So, you know, it is a true cast. It is extremely conformable. It will do all the bells and whistles. We'll go over some specifications, but the price point is something that was desired and people are looking for. Also, we see this demand, this request, installers, a lot of other brands are coming out with it, and it's that low initial tack technology. So as you can imagine, traditionally, originally when cast films and wrapping came out and started, it was the higher tack. It's a comfort, you know it's gonna stick. But this low initial tack technology that we'll go over is extremely intentional and it's really fascinating. So don't be scared of it, be curious about it. And the last thing, I thought, you know, Briteline needs a film for every type of application that our customers are coming across. So we've got anything from a 3-year promotional vinyl that is in that low $100 range, all the way up to a true cast now and everything in between. We've got photo papers, backlit films, mesh banner, window perf, you name it. We're getting to the point where we've got something for everybody. Okay, so I wanted to also talk on the basics that comes up as well, is a lot of customers ask us or don't really know the explanation between cast and calendared. So real quick, cast and calendared, two different animals. Think of it as durability, conformability, and the way it's manufactured. So durability, you're dealing with a calendared vinyl that's going to be a 3 to 5 year product. Your cast are going to give you that 7 to 10 year durability. When it comes to conformability, calendar vinyls are really intended for flat surfaces or extremely simple curves. And then lastly, price point. You can tell just by looking at the price point, there's a big difference there. So the way these are manufactured is what contributes to that. So think of calendar films as like a mold. It's rolled out like a, you know, rolled out like a dough. And then it has that memory. It wants to shrink over time. So that's why you see the little ridge of adhesive behind on some calendar decals. Cast products do not have that memory. They don't want to shrink back to their original state. So that's just the basic knowledge that a lot of new employees or new people at Grimco need to learn and understand, so you can choose the right film for the right application. So let's get into that low initial tack. This is the big topic that always comes up, and I always want to make sure people are educated on it so that they're comfortable with it. So the easy release liner, that is something, again, that this is a request when you're dealing with a large panel and you're doing it by yourself, you're doing a trailer, you're squeezing it down, you're pulling that liner with one hand, you need it to release nicely. So that low initial tack, like I mentioned before, that liner is going to release with ease. So no matter how big your panels are, you're going to be able to take them apart. So again, there's other features that low initial tack gets into, but when you're dealing with a hot summer install or you're doing something by yourself and the vinyl touches itself, there's some higher tack vinyls that it's over. Once that vinyl adhesive touches itself, it's going to stick, and then you're going to stretch, you're going to rip it, you're going to tear, you're going to cuss, and you're going to be mad. So keep in mind that this low initial tack intentionally is designed to give you that forgiveness so that you can pull this apart, touch it itself, get it all wrinkled, hit it with some heat, and it's going to lay beautifully again. Neil will show us exactly what I mean here in a second. Low initial tack. Again, I can't say this enough. It's something that we need to not be scared of or uneducated on, because then we're gonna think, oh, this is never going to stick. And I get that all the time. People saying, you know, we got a roll of WrapCAST for the first time and I think it's bad. I think the glue went away. I don't think there's any glue on it. And then we kind of go over what that actually means. Again, this release liner is going to come off single-handedly every time. So imagine this is my hood of a Ferrari that I just bought. So I just want to display, this is not going to grab it. You're going to slide this around until it's in its perfect position. So I don't even know if I can. So until you apply your pressure and heat, that adhesive is going to allow you to move all over the place. And it's going to easily pop back up. Say you step back and you've totally misaligned your graphic. You can easily go back to it. Even if a little bit of pressure has been applied, no problem. So again, don't be scared of this low initial tack. It's intended to make your install easier. So, sorry, my stuff all over here. So people think, again, I combat the argument that so many people are nervous about this adhesive. It's not going to bond. It's going to come off. It's going to lift. I applied this morning and just hit it with a little bit of pressure and a little bit of heat. This is just on a piece of max metal, but I just wanted to demonstrate how much that adhesive is already activating. Like, this is not, I'm just, and this is something I always, you know, encourage people to do. Give it time to dwell. That bond is going to start building immediately once it's hit with some heat, and it's going to continue to build up to like 24 to 48 hours in some cases, depending on how much post-heating you're doing. And another thing, you should always be post-heating. Never skip that step. So talking about spot decals, there is one thing I want to cover with WrapCAST that I don't necessarily recommend it for, which is when you're doing very small lettering, very small detail, and you need to weed it. So that low initial tack, if that comes off the liner, you're not going to be able to push it back down. So in those types of applications, we've got you covered with a high performance calendared film, 2.5 mil, a higher tack. It is conformable, but again, high performance calendared film. Also great for lettering, any decals you want to do. So keep that in mind. Talk to us if you need something along those lines. So I want to touch base real quick on what Neil's doing over here. And keep in mind, these casts, WrapCAST is not just for vehicles, you guys. This is for any time you need to step up your game from a calendared film, anytime you have any kind of body lines. This is Neil's waste ink barrel that he decided needed a little bit of character to it. So what he's doing here, he was playing around with it. He's like, let's try it here. And obviously you can see it's very conformable. Again, he's not necessarily mic'd up, so he can't give us a good explanation, but if you stretch the film, I want to zoom in if we can see where hitting it with some heat, if it's overstretched, just like you would expect any, see, look at that. That's not, so again, just as you would anticipate or expect a cast film to react to heat, you're going to have that with your WrapCAST. And I've seen some really awesome installs. Everybody likes to send me their pictures, and I can't get enough of them. Anytime you have a picture, please send it to me. We've seen anything from prosthetic legs to helmets to garage doors, you name it. The WrapCAST has gone to the test and performed successfully. So I wanted to, the most important thing I want to discuss with everybody is our laminates. These laminates are phenomenal. And I'm telling you this because that's what I'm hearing from our customers. We've got three current finishes that I'll talk about, but also these laminates are outselling the film because they're so versatile. They're being used for other types of applications. And even if somebody is just married and adamant about using their cast film they've been using for 10 plus years, they're finding these laminates are still hitting the mark when it comes to performance, finish, and affordability. So I don't think there's any other laminates out there with some of these really, really cool finishes. First, obviously the gloss. We've got the high gloss that you would expect, like a wet paint, very, very glossy. Number one seller, obviously. But then we've got your satin finish. This is what I'm talking about. There's not another laminate out there right now that has this nice of a consistent velvety sheen. It's a very, very sexy finish. And I'm telling you, once people do a wrap with it, they repeat by because they see it firsthand about how nice and how sharp that looks on the vehicle when they want to make it unique and different. And this matte laminate, this is one of the most matte laminates on the market. It is completely flat. It is an ultra matte. It dissipates the light 100%. I hope the camera can show that. I can't even get a glare. This product right here is, again, it's becoming more and more popular as that matte look looks really sharp on vehicle graphics or anything they're wanting to wrap. Kyle, I think you had mentioned one time some unique applications you saw with some of these laminates. Can you fill us in on that?
Yeah, guys, this is what's so unique about this product is its versatility. And not only are these laminates used in automotive or wrapping scenarios, but for all sorts of different scenarios. I had a particular customer that's using it as kind of a dulling diffuser films for their LEDs. And the LEDs were shining on this panel and it was creating these sharp spots within the panel itself. Applying this laminate over this aluminum was able to dull the actual lights themselves and give a nice even glow. So just kind of keep that open and think about all the different types of applications that these laminates can be used in.
Awesome. Well, yeah, that's another thing. Again, as we get more and more images that are sent to us, you can find WrapCast on GoBriteline.com and Grimco.com. We've got some galleries of other things that have been submitted. And then check out our Facebook page where we love to repost any wraps that customers do. But honestly, you guys, at the end of the day, we are committed to offering you products in Briteline that don't sacrifice quality, but do save you on your bottom line for material costs. Briteline is a true WrapCast. WrapCast is a true cast product backed by a 7-year durability warranty, and most importantly, backed by Grimco. We've got your back when it comes to any questions or concerns you have. So again, don't be scared of it. Be curious. Give it a shot. We're excited for your feedback on it. So we'll go ahead and open up now for the Q&A session. Kyle, did you get any questions during the program that we can kind of go over?
I did. A couple questions that have been coming in. Can you touch on the WrapCast and its ability to conform around rivets?
Rivets, perfect. So just like any other cast film, you're going to use your roller pro or whatever technique you want to use, but this will not tint. You run it down those rivets, it's going to hug those rivets, and it's going to stay intact. We have a customer actually that does tons of trailers for Budweiser, and it's all done with WrapCast. It's got a beautiful conformability around these rivets. You're not going to see any tinting. So again, as long as you're doing a proper install, you're going to be fine. So you can see a video we'll post a little bit later that shows an actual rivet application and how it just sucks into those tight rivets.
Erin, would you recommend that the Briteline IM3211 carpet film be laminated?
Absolutely. You've got to laminate any vinyl application that you're doing. Vinyl isn't necessarily that smooth vinyl isn't slip resistant. So the only way to make that a slip resistant application or product is going to be to laminate it with either the Briteline OLFL309 or the OLFL311. Both are on Grimco.com. So yes, laminate those always.
Great question from Malcolm here. Can you touch on the heat temperature for post-heating WrapCast?
Yes. So when you're post-heating, like you always should with any brand you use, you're going to want to post-heat at about 220 degrees on your flat surfaces, and then you can bump it up 5 to 10 degrees on those really deep channels.
Perfect. I've got a couple.
Go ahead.
So how would you compare Briteline to the rest of the competitive products out on the market in terms of recognizing name and how long they've been in the industry?
We get a lot of questions. Actually, we get that question all the time. And although obviously I want to position this as a very unique product, we are a very proud distributor for a lot of well-known brands out there that are leaders in the industry. But what sets it apart is that low initial tack. I'm telling you, it's not like any other product that we offer. It will, you know, adhere once heat and pressure is applied. But when it comes to a learning curve for an installer, I've been told, you know, I had to work with it. I had to get kind of comfortable with it. I've never used something with low initial tack. But after about halfway through, I started to really get in my groove and I understood the technology of it. So the biggest difference as far as print quality, out of the park. You're going to get some beautiful, beautiful reds, some beautiful colors that are going to be produced with this film. Again, the laminate's probably my favorite thing in the world, but it's going to be extremely comparable. Same removability warranty, same, it can handle any curves, complex, full body wraps, anything you name it. But the biggest difference is going to be that low initial tack that needs to be activated with heat and pressure, where others are extremely tacky at first. And I, like when I think about an example for you to visualize, when you're doing a large panel on the side of a truck, you know, sometimes you could just tack it up there traditionally with just, you know, your palm of your hand, pulling the liner and everything, because it's a super tacky film. You're going to need to kind of apply a little bit more pressure with the WrapCast so that it gets that grab, unlike some other high tack films.
Perfect. Another question that came in, can you touch on the suggested stretch limit? When you're stretching this film, especially on compound curves, bumpers, etc.
I tell you, the best thing to do is to take a look at the gallery on GoBriteline.com. It is extremely stretchable. It's going to stretch just as good, if not better, than the other cast films they're using. But what I really like about it is the colors stay so true when you're overstretching it. When you're going around bumpers, your blacks will stay black, your navies will stay navy, and there's really nothing that we've come across that it can't do. So, you know, anything from a very high-end sports car to a Jeep Wrangler to a Sprinter van, we've been wrapping it all. Our customers have not come across anything that it's not able to do as far as the stretchability, bumpers, door handles, helmets, you name it, it will conform.
Erin, can you touch on the different finishes on the WrapCAST laminate finishes as far as?
Good thing you asked that, because I almost forgot to mention something that is very exciting. So again, high gloss, satin, and matte. High gloss, wet paint look, satin finish is like a smooth, soft velvet. It's just outstanding. And then the matte, honestly, when I looked at a sample of the matte to sign off on it, it took me a second. I didn't know which side was the paper. It was so incredibly flat. So if you need that matte finish that catches no light, there's no other product that's going to succeed like this. But I wanted to mention, I forgot, this summer, we are going to introduce the optically clear version. So anybody that's looking for an optically clear laminate for your wraps to give it that extra oomph, we're going to have it available for you. Same price point, a nice gloss, use it on your window perf, use it on your wraps, wherever you have a need for optically clear, we're going to have the best solution for you. Anything else?
You know what? One just actually just came in. You touched on the window perf. Can you explain the different ratios that we have on that as well?
Yeah, we actually have our traditional Briteline window perf, which is offered in a 50-50 and a 65-35. We've been selling that for over 10 years. Obviously, the 50-50 leans towards the vehicle world and the 65-35 for your storefronts. But we also now have our Briteline dual liner perf. This is a unique product to us because it has that dual liner construction, which allows it to be printed on with latex, solvent, eco-solvent, UV, you name it. It is a universal liner that allows that ink to drop through. But that's a little technical side of it. The cool thing is about it, we've got 60-40, 70-30, and now 80-20. So when you're doing those storefronts or you're building wraps, if you need more surface but still visibility, go with the 80-20 ratio. It's going to give you more surface for your ink, and the colors and the prints are going to look phenomenal. So check those out for sure.
Can you also answer the thickness of for the WrapCAST laminate?
Yes. The film and the laminate are a 2 mil thickness. So both extremely, like I've mentioned, extremely conformable, but they are the 2 mil thickness. The product I talked about, the IM330, write that down, because if you need something that is in that high performance calendar, 7 year durability, great for partial wraps, or when you need a little bit more conformability than a traditional calendar film, the thickness on that is 2.4. So that just shows you a traditional calendar film, typically about 3, 3.5, that IM330 part number is a 2.4. There's also matching laminates that go with that, offered in gloss and matte as well.
Is there a wall vinyl? Can the WrapCAST be used as a wall vinyl?
It can, actually. We've got some great images that people have done in their buildings, their interior walls with WrapCAST. I haven't tested it. I wouldn't recommend necessarily, just because we haven't gone through all the extensive testing that we do with every Briteline product on a very, very textured brick wall. But as far as, you know, needing to do wall wraps interior for smooth or simple curves or whatever, we've got a lot of customers that have done a tremendous amount of wall graphics with the WrapCAST product. So yes.
Just to kind of clarify, Dave Freezer asks, do you mean the WrapCAST vinyl will come this summer in a clear? I believe you mentioned.
No, I'm sorry. This summer, the laminate. We are going to offer a laminate, a clear, optically clear laminate. But now you've got my wheels turning. Maybe we need a clear print vinyl as well. Dave, I'll send you a check in the mail. And we'll name it after you. Anything else?
Well, let's see here.
Come on, fire away, people.
What temp can the window vinyl be installed at?
Traditionally, window vinyls, we always recommend a 40 degree application temperature with a service temp from 40 to 180. So 40 degrees Fahrenheit is pretty common for a lot of installs when it comes to surface temperature. So I kind of always stick with that. It's recommended for the majority of your installs. which I don't think the windows will hit that today in Chicago.
Would you recommend that the wall vinyl be tested for adhesion before they print?
Absolutely. Not just WrapCast. Any vinyl you're putting on walls. Walls are like snowflakes, or like jeans. No two pairs fit alike, I think. I think the biggest thing is to take that. If you want to tell your customer, look, I want to ensure that you're happy. I want to ensure this application goes well and you come back next time you need something. I'm going to come on site, if you're available to, and put a unprinted sample on their wall. And I'm telling you what I've kind of found, if that sample doesn't come down within 48 hours, you're set. You're pretty good to go. Because again, the problem is with failures on wall graphics is there's something that's preventing that bond. It could be anything from an extremely low VOC paint that isn't technically ready for vinyl to be applied to it, or a non-low VOC paint that's still outgassing. But like I mentioned before, a lot of people don't realize that outgassing process, when it's done, it's not technically done. You got to remove that stuff that was left behind during it. So again, it's a simple preventable step to do when you are doing wall decals. So definitely always recommend testing it. But as you use more and more of the Rad Graphics products, you'll get a feel and you'll get a trust for it. And you'll understand that, you know, it's got your back and it's going to work. So really wall prep. That's the most important thing in my opinion. All right.
Question before we wrap up. What would you recommend to clean the wall before they apply their wall graphics?
I would recommend a 70% isopropyl alcohol or 90% and mix it with water. So you're going to want to do about a 70-30 ratio whenever you're mixing that, some warm water, and then a nice lint-free cloth, and just wipe that wall down just like you would a countertop. You're not soaking the wall. You're not, you know, mopping the deck with it, but you just want to get that alcohol. As you know, alcohol evaporates very quickly. So as long as you give it some time to breathe after you've wiped it down, you'll be good to go. So just your everyday isopropyl alcohol and a water mixture. Wipe it down, let it breathe, and then apply. Because again, if you don't, you don't know what's on that wall. You may not be able to see it. You don't know what's on it, especially if it's a wall that, you know, is in a pediatric waiting center. You know, think about all the people touching those walls, all the kids touching those walls. If you don't clean it, you're just putting that film right onto that residue, right onto that dirt, and it can't get that nice adhesion.
Erin, where can they go for color profiles for their printers?
Color profiles, well, what we can do is I can tell you Grimco.com after you sign in and go to software support. We've got a ton of profiles on there for Briteline and Duratex products. But the biggest thing, going back to the introduction, this demo center is made to make you successful. We are set up to help you get your job done correctly, and we want to guide you to that direction. We've got Neil, and then we've got a whole tech support team that is ready to help you if you have some questions about profiling. Profiling is something, again, I think a lot of people want to walk up to their printer and say, go. Well, sometimes we need to do some tweaks. Sometimes the heating needs to be adjusted. But color profiles and everything as far as that support, look on Grimco.com or give us a call. Any more? How are we doing on time? Good?
I think we're pretty good. Yeah.
Think we're pretty good. All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining and stopping by our booth here on the WrapCast Briteline demonstration. If you've got any questions at all, let's keep talking about this. We're not slowing down, even though the world might feel like it is. We're ready to help you. We're ready to find you solutions, and we're ready to be here to support you. Thank you so much for tuning in.